Hey there, YouTube. This is Tolstoy Kafkaevsky coming back for the second time this weekend to do another video review. Well, sort of more just a neat little video because it was kind of cruising around at Walmart and I picked up something I've been meaning to do a video about, kind of. Now, let's see. In the, we'll call it the alternative sports world, there are two types of gun replica sports that are kind of at war, which is airsoft and paintball. And I kind of started thinking about it, like, I talked to all the paintball weirdos at work, and, you know, they all say, you know, oh, man, they say that airsoft is for losers, man, because it doesn't, like, mark your clothes, and it doesn't hurt or cost as much, and the guns look like better replicas, and I don't know, whatever. If you're really into paintball, that's neat. I think paintball is... I'm not even gonna get into that. I think by now you kind of figure out what I bought. For $10 at a Walmart, I bought an airsoft pistol. And this is what it looks like. This is clear plastic one because this is a nice Chinese ripoff. This is not a Tokyo Marui, or I don't know how to pronounce that, model. So this really isn't... It's a replica, but it's not a very good replica of whatever type of gun this is supposed to be. An interesting story. I was being rung up by a Frenchman who was actually working in the sports department, and he seemed to have trouble working the cash register because I couldn't get my gift card scanned. Eventually I just had to pay for it with debit, which kind of sucked, but it was only $10, so about $11 for this. We'll go over the features. It's a supposedly a came with these here instructions. The instructions say it is a type of Sig Sauer P228. I don't really know if it's a real gun model. It sounds about right. It's got instructions on how to, you know, handle it and stuff like that. And it's in multiple languages, but the English is kind of interesting. Let's see. Don't look inside the barrel. Never aim at the creature. Be careful to avoid rebouncing. Keep out of reach of children. And, yeah, that's about it. So, anyway, it's got some weird English in there, so you can see it was made in China. Looking at the build-up of it, you have your top right here, which basically works the same. This is not a semi-automatic. There are three types of airsofts, if my research is true, and that is that there are single bolt action, or like almost like a single action you have to keep every time you want to unload a new round. And then there are semi-automatics and all fully automatics that are made with gas or electric power, i.e. a little battery motor that will allow you to lay down multiple rounds. This particular model ironically comes with a safety right there, so you pull that down and, well, you know, you're not going to be shooting at anyone. And of course this little button here, which is the clip evacuation. This is the magazine, which holds rounds by you. Came with, here you go, these here little BB pellet things, which the bag is kind of leaking, so they like one likes to come out every now and again. There you go, these little BBs. Ooh, dropped it. Little BBs that you load into the cartridge like so, and as you can see, it's in there, and then you lock it into the firearm, take the safety off, it's on, and you cock it once, and then she's actually ready to fire. But of course, I don't want to fire on the inside. Ooh, shit. I did not know that. Now I can't, I wonder if I can, hold on. Great, now the only way to defuse it now is to pull the trigger. Huh. Okay, I'm going to shoot it into a drawer. Open up. Well, it went somewhere in there. Either way, I think she's safe now. I hope. I have a difficult time cocking it with the... I can't shoot with the right hand. I have a difficult time cocking it with my left. I fear that I have to hold on to it. Do it with my, yeah, you know. With my only problem is that with using it with the left hand, as you can see, there's the release, and oftentimes when I go to pull the trigger, I'll, oops, accidentally eject my clip. I'll have to figure out some adaptive way of doing it, but of course, since it's not a semi-automatic, if I wanted to lay down multiple rounds, I'd have to quickly, you know. Yeah. Just like Metal Gear Solid, you have to quick, you know, reload the round, like the Beretta M9, the altered tranquilizer darts. Okay, so you probably want to see this in action, but I'm not going to shoot it on in here, so, let's take this outside and do some neat footage with it, shall we?
Listen, all you killing all freaks. No, killing all freaks now. Yo, yo, calling all.
Alright guys, let's go play with some potentially dangerous toys. Okay, just to be clear, in the movies they always cock the gun before they put it away in their coat, and that's really unsafe because, just put this out there as a public safety measure. It's totally unsafe when you see that in movies, because, I mean, like, well, if you cock it and you put it away, something in the chamber could go off, and there goes your foot. So, remember, if you're going to put it away, if you're going to holster it, don't cock it. Put the safety on. Eject the clip. Okay. Alright, this is my upper back deck. Down there you can see my lower back deck, which is still in a mess from when I did my katana thing. And right now, first things first, we're going to load the chamber. We're going to load the gun. Set you down. It is actually kind of cold out. Ew. What's going on that chair? Ew. I'm a manly man, but I don't want to get my coat spoiled. Okay. Just sweep some of this gook off here. Okay. It'll be alright. Okay. So, first things first, take the gun, eject the chamber. As you can see, or not the chamber, the, Lord, it looks like I don't know my gun terminology. The magazine, the clip. Now, as you can kind of see, there's like a little spring in there, and that lets you load up. This instruction says 13 rounds or little pellets. Get it round because they're round. First things first, I'm gonna load a single one in. This ought to make a neat clip. I'm going to fire this firearm into that little plastic container, and then probably slow it down to slow motion. Okay. Dig it. Well, you know what? Let me get you a better view. There you go, man.